Hey guys, welcome to another video. My name is Lana from millennialships.com, your place for self-care and relationship advice. And today I'm going to be going over 5 easy steps to make you small talk like a pro. Hey guys, welcome to another video. So today I'm going to be talking about small talk and how you can use a few little tips to help you in conversations with people that you might not know, or if you are in some kind of networking event or at a party or something like that, and you're going to be forced to talk to people that you've never met before. And sometimes it can be a challenge, especially if you're an introvert like me, or if you have social anxiety or something like that. It can be a bit of a challenge. So the first thing that I have to mention, it seems obvious, but really it's like you have to change your mindset. So small talk, I know it sounds kind of dumb and it's a little bit of a chore. I mean, it's a chore for everybody. Nobody really enjoys small talk. And the truth is, like, back when I was like in university and I hated talking to other people and people I didn't know, for me, it was one of those things where I was like, well, I prefer having deeper, more meaningful conversations. I prefer having real conversations about real things. I don't like just mingling and chatting about things that are not intellectual or useful. And the truth is, yeah, I mean, sure, like that's how everybody thinks of conversations. Everybody would rather have a conversation that means a little bit more or is really funny or you're really connecting. Nobody really wants to talk about the weather. But the truth is, you know, that's how you start relationships. You can't put the cart before the horse, right? Like you have to start a relationship with a mundane, easy conversation, and then it's going to get into something a little bit deeper. So that's how you're going to start the relationship of, you know, the love of your life. That's how you're going to start the relationship with your boss, with your best friend. If you're not related to that person, like with blood, like family, then, you know, your relationships are all going to start with a small talk conversation. So when you look at it that way, it's going to make it a lot easier to be like, well, okay, maybe I don't mind chatting about the weather for a little bit, because that's really just me sussing out whether or not I actually want to continue a relationship with this person. The first thing is that you don't talk. So instead of talking or trying to think of things to say, focus on listening. Focus on showing that person that you're hearing their story, that you're hearing what they have to say, and that you're interested in them. Sometimes if you're going guns a-blazing, trying to chat about things or asking a bunch of questions or telling stories about yourself, that actually can be off-putting. And that can be a little bit less of a relationship building technique than just staying calm and listening and really hearing what the person has to say. I have definitely talked to people who, whenever I was talking to them, it didn't really sound like they were, or didn't really seem like they were listening. It just kind of seemed like they maybe were waiting for the next thing to say, or like they just weren't really paying attention. And that's just not a really great way to connect with people. You want to show that you're interested in them. So a great way to do that is by stop talking and start listening. Then the next thing is to show interest. So you can do this in 2 different ways. An example first about how I found out that these 2 things are so important. And it was because I was chatting with this lady one time when I was working in film, and she was like the nicest lady ever. And I just like, I loved her. I thought she was such a great person. I felt that I could just chat with her for hours. And the truth is, we probably were chatting for about 30 minutes, I would say. Maybe talk to this person for 30 minutes ever. And I came away thinking that she was the nicest person ever and that I would be comfortable telling her all my secrets. So what did she do? What did she have that had this big impact on me? And the truth is, she had just mastered these 2 things. And the first thing is intrigue. So intrigue means that you are curious about what the person is saying, that you're interested in learning more. And this lady, she just had that down pat. If I were to say that I'm into mountain biking, she would say, oh, wow, like mountain biking, what? Okay, so what does that actually mean? Like, do you go up the mountain or do you use a chairlift? And then, so she would start asking me questions. And I was happy to talk about this thing because I had already mentioned that that's something that I enjoy doing. So you can do this too. All you have to do is kind of act as though, or really be interested in what they're saying and learning more about that topic. You need to do that to everything they say. So if they say that they're into something that you might not like at all, like if they say that they're into knitting, you know, something boring, right? Just be like, hey, that's really cool. Like, okay, so, you know, what kind of things do you knit? Or if I wanted to learn, would it be difficult? You know, and asking questions about that thing, and they're going to go on and on because they love talking about that thing. And they're going to really like you because it's going to show them that you accept them for who they are and that you're interested in what they're interested in. So that's going to take you a long way. And then the other thing, the other side of that is enthusiasm. So every time I mention something to this lady about something that I did or something that I liked, she was always really enthusiastic about that thing. And she would go out of her way to just be like, oh, wow, that's super cool. Or that's really interesting. This can also be like, if somebody's telling you a story about, you know, how they broke their leg or something like that, you know, not a fun story. Even just kind of reacting in a way that's like, oh my gosh, you know, oh, that's so painful, or oh, that's just awful. You know, if you're showing enthusiasm, like showing that you're really interested in what they're saying and what they're talking about, they're gonna wanna keep on talking to you and you're just gonna be like the coolest person in the whole room. So intrigue and enthusiasm are two ways that you can really up your small talk skills. And just thing is to memorize some conversation starters. I'm not really a huge fan of this just because, you know, I feel like if you're memorizing conversation starters, it can feel a little bit robotic sometimes. You know, it's like, oh, have you seen any movies lately? I don't know. It can be a little bit robotic. Just make sure that when you're thinking of conversation starters, that they are something that you're also interested in. That can help a lot. I was in the film industry for many years. I really enjoy movies and filmmaking. So if I ask a question like, have you seen any good movies lately? The chances of them answering and me knowing what film they're talking about and being able to continue that into a larger conversation is pretty high. So that's what I would suggest with your conversation starters. You know, you don't want to keep it too, you don't want to be too specific about it, but you want to make a, you know, have a general conversation topic that you also enjoy talking about so you can keep the conversation going fairly easily. Those are my these on first dates or relationships with, you know, coworkers or a boss in an interview. It's going to really help you go a long way with meeting new people and establishing relationships. So if you guys like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my YouTube channel if you're liking these videos. And I will see you next time.